I would end with this picture showing. I was interviewed by a Swedish journalist a couple of weeks ago, and she said all the time, like a mantra, that the majority of researchers say that this is safe. There is no risk whatsoever with anything with radio frequency. She had interviewed before me a Swedish prominent person, Maria Fechting. But what you can think of is that this is a majority, is not the majority. They are quite few. The majority have, for example, signed the EMF Science Appeal, which is almost 250 scientists that have signed it, and all with their own research in this area, like Martin Paul and others. These persons are sitting in different organizations, as you can see here, within WHO group, expert group, within ICNIRP, without United States, AGNIR, without the Swedish Radiation Protection Agency, and with SKINIR. And the problem is here that you will get repetition of what is said, because, for example, Maria Fechting, she says that she's not here to defend, but she has heard this from me before, so she knows it. She can say, but look here, ICNIRP came to the same conclusion, and look here in United Kingdom, AGNIR, and the Swedish Radiation Protection Agency, they came to the same conclusion. The problem is that it's the same persons. If you in ICNIRP come to one conclusion, you are not expected to go to another organization and come to a different conclusion. So this is a very dangerous situation, because like SSM in Sweden, they are not allowing any critical person. All the persons who are sitting there are those yes or no sayers. I mean, they say, no, there is not any risk. And they make their assessment yearly, updating what evidence has come. They do not make an overview of several years, for example, what is the total pattern. For example, when the NTP study came out with the American Animal Study, Maria Fechting was very quick to go out to media and say, well, yes, look here, the researchers who were doing the microscopic studies of exposed and unexposed animals, they knew what animals were exposed and who was not exposed, so they were biased. And NTP was contacted and said, this was not the case. We have good qualification of what we are doing, and this is published. But I mean, if you can't do anything else, you create doubt. I mean, like a book which is written, doubt is their product, which comes from industry. So I would say that the situation just now is more alike than this. And we need people to waken up. The scientific data are there. It's clearly this type of radiation is dangerous to human health and maybe to nature. And I would say that it's time to act and not to let 5G to be implemented all over the world until research has been done. I mean, it's fine if there is no risk, but that needs to be shown.